Hey, this is Sean Nalawani of EliteImpactLabs.com, and today I want to talk about another traditional bodybuilding method, which is the practice of performing cardio first thing in the morning on an empty stomach. Now, this has been a popular fat-burning strategy among bodybuilders for a really long time, and if you look at it on the surface, it does seem to make sense. You know, you'd think since there's no food in the stomach and since glycogen levels are low, the body will be forced to use more body fat for energy during the session, and as a result, you'll lose fat faster. In reality, just like the eat protein every 3 hours rule, the post-workout shake obsession, and the eat clean 24/7 approach, fasted cardio appears to be another piece of traditional bodybuilding advice that when you look at it closer, it just comes up short. Although this is ultimately a very, very complicated issue, let's just go over the main points here. So first off, the body is a far more complex and intricate system than most of us could imagine. And its specific use of fuel during exercise is constantly changing and is affected by a ton of different internal factors, such as different hormones and enzymes. And the attempt to burn greater amounts of fat by exercising on an empty stomach is a very oversimplified approach to a much more complex overall picture. Secondly, worrying about what happens in small spans of 30 to 60 minutes is an incredibly short-sighted view of fat loss. The process of losing fat is all about the big picture and what you do over the course of several days, not hours. For example, it appears that if more carbohydrates are burned during exercise, then you'll simply end up burning more fat for fuel later on in the day. And in the same way, if you burn more fat during exercise, then more carbohydrates are burned later on. In other words, looking at overall 24-hour energy expenditure is definitely the most important factor here. Thirdly, doing cardio on an empty stomach doesn't even appear to burn more fat in the first place. Fasted cardio does increase lipolysis, which is the amount of fat that is broken down and released, but it doesn't actually increase fat oxidation, which is the amount of fat that you actually burn. In other words, fasted cardio causes the body to break down more fat than it can actually use for energy in the first place. And when it comes to fat loss, the limiting factor is fat oxidation, not lipolysis. In the end, those fatty acids that aren't used for fuel are simply restored as body fat. Fourth, having a pre-cardio meal actually appears to increase the thermic effect of exercise. So not only does fasted cardio have minimal to no direct effect on fat loss, but fed cardio may actually be superior. And this is because having a meal in you first appears to increase post-exercise oxygen consumption, which basically means that you'll burn more total calories even after the session is over. Fifth, performing cardio in a fasted state reduces exercise intensity. At the end of the day, effective cardio is all about maximizing the total number of calories burned. And the more total intensity that you generate, the greater the calorie burning effect will be. In most people, performing cardio first thing in the morning on an empty stomach will have a significant negative impact on overall exercise intensity in comparison to having a meal first. And lastly, fasted cardio causes a greater degree of muscle loss. The research has shown that nitrogen losses are nearly doubled when cardio is performed on an empty stomach. So if you're trying to burn fat while maintaining as much muscle as possible, fasted cardio is probably not the smartest choice. So to sum this all up, not only does fasted cardio appear to not increase fat loss during exercise, but it may actually lower the total amount of fat that's burned due to a decrease in post-exercise oxygen consumption and a reduction in overall training intensity. And in addition, fasted cardio causes you to lose more muscle. So the bottom line here is that if you're looking to maximize fat loss while minimizing muscle loss, it's probably best to get a meal in at least a few hours prior to your cardio sessions. Fasted cardio does not produce any clear, distinct fat burning advantages, and if anything, it may be counterproductive. So I hope you found this information useful. To get your complete bodybuilding program, which also includes fat loss and cardio guidelines as well, make sure to grab your free copy of the no-fail system over on EliteImpactLabs.com, and the link for that is in the description bar. Also, make sure to subscribe if you haven't already, and make sure to join the Elite Impact Labs Facebook page where we do free supplement giveaways every Sunday night. So thanks for watching this video lesson, and I'll talk to you again soon.